think of NHL players that are fleet of foot, Chris Stewart isn't someone who immediately comes to mind, but he may very well be the fastest player on skates off the ice. This is his pregame ritual. He does this at home and on the road. Tonight, the ACC offered a unique challenge, a set of stairs. It didn't stop him, though. We have seen lots of unique warm-up rituals from NHL players, but none may be as complex as Nate Schmidt's. He calls this his magic trick, and he does it before every single game. It's something he started back in junior. He ends by drinking all three bottles. There's a lot of boring ways to get hydrated. That is not one of them. At the same time every game, Anderson will put his headphones in and begin his pregame ritual. He has not changed this routine or the music playlist he listens to for at least the last 7 or 8 years. He told me it's a lot of old Eminem and Jay-Z that helps him get into the zone, although he did admit recently that he added some Taylor Swift. Sagan, he always has to be the last player off the ice during warm-up. Now, he kept a close eye on Mitch Marner, who was throwing pucks to the fans. He waited, fate going off, and the moment Marner went off, you'll see he lifted his right foot, but it wasn't until Marner stepped off the ice that Sagan finally reluctantly left the ice.
This is what Hedman does in every warm-up with the equipment man. And
there's not a chance I would put my hand down there.
He hasn't been perfect this year, but nobody's gone on IR yet either.
How about little routines in warm-up? You think about hand-eye coordination. A lot of players you see throwing pucks around. This was him on his knees keeping the puck alive. And there's some pretty serious hand-eye good coordination. That'll get you dialed in. Pre-game, here's the ritual. You got it, kid. Take us out. He gets to come on. And he got three skates. He got three rounds. Usually it's like one round. He got three.